What's up? Dr. Swole here, MD bodybuilder, back with another video in my Basics of Training series. So I got asked a question on one of my YouTube videos about how long we should be resting in between sets. And today we're going to answer that question. So starting off with the research we have right now, there have been a few studies testing rest periods sort of between 30 seconds and 5 minutes. And what those studies showed was that there was no major effect on hypertrophy when changing rest intervals, but there may be a slight benefit of longer rest intervals. We're going to talk about why this might be. Now, it's important to consider that among the variables in a training program, training volume is king. So I want you to be thinking about training volume as we go through this. And this is defined as the number of sets times reps times load. Ultimately, when choosing the length of our rest intervals, it's going to come down to a trade-off between efficiency and volume. All right, so here's a graph I made to conceptually explain these concepts. On the x-axis, you've got time in terms of length of your rest periods in minutes. And then we've got efficiency in black and then volume. Now you can see that efficiency goes down as we spend more time in between sets, which makes sense because we're taking longer in the gym. I propose that volume goes up in this S-shaped fashion as you spend longer time in between sets. Now let's see what this implies for different lengths of rest intervals. First of all, if you're resting for less than a minute in between sets, as you can see, you're pretty efficient. You're saving a bit of time in between sets. However, you're going to lose some volume. This is because fatigue will impair your ability to perform well on the next set, and you won't be able to get in as many reps or lift as much weight as you otherwise would have, which decreases volume. For example, if you imagine doing a heavy set of 5 on the deadlift and resting for only a minute and trying to repeat that set, you're going to get far fewer reps. Between 1 and 5 minutes, I would say that you're maximizing the productivity of your sets in terms of volume, while still keeping efficiency pretty high and keeping your workout moving. As rest periods get longer, you'll see that you're not really getting more productive volume since you're already fully recovered, but your workouts are taking much longer. You might say that I want to take longer rest periods to really maximize the amount of volume I get out of each set in terms of reps and weight performed. However, if you think about it, with your workout getting so long, you may as well take shorter rest periods and actually fit in more sets, which also increases your volume. Okay, so let's boil this down into some practical recommendations. Basically, we want to keep our rest periods as short as possible in order to maximize efficiency while still getting most of our recovery in between sets so that our performance stays high. For most exercises, this means about 1 to 2 minutes of rest in between sets. And for heavy compound movements, you'll probably want to be in the 3 to 5 minute range. Where you go exactly in this range will depend on how your body responds to certain exercises. For me, for example, I tend to take 1 to 1.5 minute rests for isolation work like bicep curls or tricep press downs, and more like 2 minutes for machine type compound movements like lat pull downs or leg presses. In terms of my heavy compounds, when I'm doing heavy sets of bench press, I'll be taking 3 minutes rest. And when I'm doing heavy squats or deadlifts, I might take up to 5 minutes rest. Sometimes I'll time my rest periods with a stopwatch, but this isn't necessary. I think you should be resting until you feel you're ready to perform the next set well and that you can keep your reps up. It's normal for your reps to drop a little bit throughout the course of a workout, but if your reps are dropping drastically in between sets, you may consider taking a longer rest break. For example, when doing sets of 12, it's pretty common for me to see my reps go down from, say, 12, 11, and then 10, but it would not be ideal in terms of volume if I saw my reps going down from 12 to 7 to 4. That's all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, and leave me a comment below. Let me know what you think about my recommendations for rest periods. See you next time.